Hello everyone, let us discuss the process of transcription, its general concept. So transcription I will discuss in two parts, that prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription. Here now I am giving the lecture of the basic general concept of the transcription that you should know before proceeding towards the actual steps of transcription. So the first stage is the expression of genetic information, that is transcription of the information in the base sequence of double-stranded molecule to form the base sequence of single-stranded molecule of RNA. So from DNA, RNA is formed, that is known as the transcription. For any particular gene, only one strand of DNA molecule, that is the template strand, is copied by the RNA polymerase as it synthesizes RNA in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction. 5 prime to 3 prime direction. Because RNA polymerase moves in the 3 prime to 5 prime direction along the template strand of DNA, the RNA product is anti-parallel and complementary to the template. The RNA polymerase recognizes start signal, that is promoter. RNA polymerase recognizes the start signal, that is polymerase, and stop signals, that is terminators. For each of the thousand of transcription units in the genome of the organism. So RNA polymerase recognizes the promoter, it recognizes the transcription. In between them, the gene from the DNA is transcribed in the 3 prime 5 prime direction. So now let us discuss the other general concept of the transcription. The RNA is synthesized by a DNA dependent RNA polymerase. It uses DNA as the template for the synthesis of RNA. So let us proceed forward. The RNA polymerase locates gene in the DNA by searching for promoter region. The promoter is the binding site of RNA polymerase. Here, the RNA polymerase bind the promoter region. RNA polymerase bind in the promoter region. The binding establishes where the transcription begins. Which strand of DNA is used as template and in which direction transcription proceeds. So in the transcription, no primer is required. The RNA polymerase move along the template strand in the 3 prime 5 prime direction and is synthesized the RNA product in the 5 prime 3 prime direction using the ATP, GTP, CTP and UTP as the substrate. RNA polymerase do not proofread its work. The RNA product is complementary and anti-parallel to the template strand. Here you should really know this. In the DNA there are two strands, the coding strand and the template strand. So let us suppose the RNA polymerase uses the template strand for the production of the RNA. So the RNA is anti-parallel and complementary to the template strand, but the RNA copy is exactly same as the coding strand, except that there is uracil in presence of thymine in the RNA. So the coding anti-tamarin strand is not used during transcription. It is identical in the sequence to the RNA molecule except that RNA contains uracil instead of thymine that is found in the DNA. So by convention, the base sequence of the gene is given from the coding strand. So let us suppose the coding strand is ATGCAT and the template strand is TACGTA. It is the DNA sequence. It is the DNA sequence. So when the RNA polymerase transcribe, the RNA form is AUGCAU. See this RNA, see this newly formed RNA. It is antiparallel and complementary to the template strand, but it is exactly same as the coding strand, except for T for U. In the vicinity of the gene, a numbering system is used to identify the location of the important bases. The first base transcribed as RNA is defined as the plus one. The first base transcribed is plus one. To the left, 5' or upstream of this starting point for transcription, the bases are minus one, minus two, minus three, minus four, minus five, minus six, and so on. And to the right, there are plus two, plus three, plus four, and so on. The transcription ends when the RNA polymerase reaches the termination signal. So this is the general concept you should know in the transcription. So now let us begin the actual concept of the prokaryotic transcription and eukaryotic transcription. So now let us discuss about the transcription in prokaryotes. The specific region of DNA where enzyme binds the RNA polymerase binds is known as the promoter region. The binding of enzyme RNA polymerase to DNA is prerequisite for the transcription to start. So there are two base sequences on the coding DNA strand which the sigma factor of the RNA polymerase can recognize for the initiation of the transcription. These are, one is Tata box, which is also known as Pibno box, consists of six nucleotide bases TATAAT, and the 35 sequence consists of the basis sequence TTGACA. So the initiation begins after the sigma factor binds to the promoter region. After the binding of the sigma factor, what happens? So the RNA polymerase recognizes the promoter region. The sigma factor which has initially bound is released. It is released and then transcription proceeds. The RNA is synthesized from the 5 prime to 3 prime end, which is antiparallel to the DNA template. The RNA polymerase utilizes ribonucleotide triphosphate such as ATP, GTP, CTP, UTP for the formation of the RNA. For addition of each nucleotide to the growing chain, a phosphate moiety is released. The sequence of nucleotide bases in the mRNA is complementary to the template strand, and it is, however, identical to that of the coding strand, except the RNA contains uracil in place of the thymine in the DNA. So now let us discuss to the termination. How the transcription is terminated in the prokaryotes. The process of transcription is stopped by two termination signals. One is rho dependent, another is rho independent. In the rho dependent termination, a specific protein known as rho factor binds to the growing RNA or weakly to the DNA. In the bound state, it acts as the ATPase and terminates the transcription and releases the RNA. The rho factor is also responsible for the dissociation of the RNA polymerase from the DNA. The rho independent termination, however, in this case is brought by the formation of hairpin of newly synthesized RNA. This occurs due to the palindromes. The presence of palindromes in the base sequence of DNA template in the termination is known. As a result of this, the newly synthesized RNA folds to form the hairpins due to complementary base pairing. And this causes the termination of the transcription. So this is the concept of the transcription in the prokaryotes. The transcription and translation can occur simultaneously in the bacteria because there is no processing of the prokaryotic mRNA because there are no introns. The ribosome can begin translating the message even before the transcription is complete. The ribosome binds to the sequence called the Cine-Dalgarno sequence. In the 5' untranslated region of the message, the protein synthesis begins at an AUG codon at the beginning of the codon region and continues until the ribosome reaches at the stop codon at the end of the coding region. The ribosome translates the message in the 5' to 3' direction, synthesizes the protein from amino terminus to carboxyl terminus. The detail about the translation, the formation of the protein from the mRNA, I will discuss later. The mRNA produced by the gene shown in the figure is monocystronic message. That is, it is transcribed from the single gene is transcribed and code for only single protein. The word cystone is another name for a gene. Some bacteria operons, for example lactose operon, which I have discussed earlier, produce polycystronic messages. In these cases, related gene grouped together in the DNA are transcribed as one unit. The mRNA in this case contains transformation from several genes and code for several different proteins. Now let us discuss about the transcription of eukaryotic gene. In eukaryotes, most genes are composed of the coding segments, which is also known as the exons, which are interrupted by the non-coding segments, which are known as introns. Both exons and introns are transcribed in the nucleus. Introns are removed during the processing of the RNA molecule in the nucleus. In the eukaryotes, all mRNA is monocystronic. The mature mRNA is translated in the cytoplasm. The structure and the transcription of the typical eukaryotic gene coding for a protein is illustrated here. With the help of a protein called transcription factors, RNA polymerase II recognizes and binds to the promoter region. The basal promoter regions of eukaryotic genes has usually two regions called the Tata box and another is CAAT box. The Tata box is also called the Ognase box. The RNA polymerase II. The RNA polymerase II separates the strand of the DNA over the short region to initiate the transcription and read the DNA sequence. The template strand is read in the 3' to 5' direction. As the RNA product is primary transcript, the RNA initial product is always known as the primary transcript, which is synthesized in the 5 prime to 3 prime direction. Both exons and introns are transcribed, but later the introns are removed. The RNA polymerase 2 in its transcription where it reaches the termination signal. These signals are not well understood in the eukaryotes. So now let us discuss about the processing of the eukaryotic pre-messenger RNA. This is the formation of the pre-mRNA. And now let us discuss about the formation of the processing of the eukaryotic pre-messenger RNA. Now let us discuss about the RNA processing in the eukaryotes. The pre-RNA needs to go the series of transformation, which is known as the RNA processing, before the formation of the mRNA. So the initial processing occurs, the capping of the 5 prime end, then there is the polyadenylation of the 3 prime end, then there is the splicing out of the introns. So a 7 methyl guanosine cap is added to the 5 prime end. The 7 methyl guanosine cap is added to the 5 prime end while the RNA molecule is still being synthesized. The cap structure serves as the ribosome binding site and also helps to protect the mRNA chain from degradation. Another is the polyadenylation of the 3 prime end. The poly A tail is attached to the 3 prime end. In this process, an endonuclease causes the molecule on the 3 prime side of the sequence. That is AAU-AAA. Which is also known as the poly A addition signal. Then the poly A polymerase adds the poly A tail about 200 A's to the new 3 prime end. The poly A tail protects the message against rapid degradation and aids in the transport to the cytoplasm. A few mRNAs, for example, histone mRNA, have no poly A tails. Now there is the splicing out of the introns. So let us discuss about the splicing out of the introns. The introns are removed from the pre-mRNA. The pre-mRNA is also known as the Yasian RNA. Introns are removed from the Yasian RNA by splicing, which is accomplished by the spliceosomes, also known as SNRP or SNURP, which are complexes of the SNRNA and the protein. The primary transcript combines with the small nuclear ribonuclear proteins, SNRPs. And other proteins to form the spliceosomes. The cleavage at the 5' splice site, and there is the formation of, there is cleavage at the 5' splice site, and there is the formation of the lariat shaped loop intermediate is generated. This lariat shaped intermediate is generated. And then there is the cleavage at the 3' site. Cleavage at the 3' splice site. The lariat is released precisely to remove the intron. And there is the joining of the two exons. So this is the RNA processing in the eukaryotes. The capped Yasian RNA, the tailed Yasian RNA, and the spliced Yasian RNA is known as the mature messenger RNA, which undergoes the translation. So this much for the transcription of the eukaryotes. So now we have concluded. So now we have concluded the RNA processing in the eukaryotes. So in this lecture, we read about the transcription as the general concept, and the, we read about the transcription in the prokaryotes and the transcription of the eukaryotes and the processing of the hnRNA, which eventually leads to the formation of the mRNA. Thank you this much for today for the transcription.